Stanford University.
What we're doing with the Kelp Forest Array is bringing the laboratory to the field. It provides the power and data to be able to basically do any experiment you do in the lab. And what that allows is that the animals that you might be studying or the chemistry that you're studying is in its natural environment. It's not being manipulated in any way. The data we're gathering with the Kelp Forest Array are basic oceanographic things like temperature, salinity, the current direction and speed, so where the waters are going and where they're coming from, pH to look at ocean acidification, dissolved oxygen data to look at hypoxia. The amount of data we're collecting is pretty mind-boggling. We'll be actually generating, for those of you who are tech savvy, about a gigabyte an hour. It's surrounded by kelp and rockfish, abalone, seals, sea lions, sea otters. Being down in the kelp forest is pretty amazing. It's not unlike being in, say, a redwood forest on shore when you're hiking around. You have these immense plants that are going up from you. You get a lot of sunlight that comes through, so you get these beautiful rays of sunlight. And the colors are actually quite amazing and intense as well. You have white ascidians, and then you have some abalone, and then you have red and orange coral and algae. They're some of the most beautiful exotic places on Earth, and we want to understand them so that we can protect them for now and in the future.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.